Today on Made to Hack, I replaced the cells in some battery packs. I bought this used, fine cordless screwdriver knowing that the battery packs were dead. The first step was to open each battery pack and inspect the NiCd cells inside. As can be seen, the battery contact tabs are very much corroded with copper sulfate oxidation. I removed the cell packs from the battery holders. Since copper sulfate is slightly acidic in water, I made a solution of detergent, which is slightly alkaline. Together, they should neutralize each other. However, I did wear gloves during the cleaning process. I proceeded to wash the battery compartments and all of the plastic parts. I bought these 1700 mAh cells that I found online. If their stated capacity is authentic, they would hold twice the amount of charge as the original Cadnicas. After charging them for 16 hours at 1/10 C rating, I verified that they all held a similar charge in order to build the first battery pack. I also picked up a pack of battery tabs that needed to be attached to both ends of each cell. My attempt at a makeshift tab welder using a car battery was a dismal failure. I decided to solder the tabs to the batteries instead. I sanded each of the individual cells using an abrasive sandpaper in order to give the solder something to attach to. Once this was done, I proceeded to begin soldering the battery tabs to the individual cells. Notice, this is not the correct way to attach battery tabs to cells. You should use a tab welder if possible, as opposed to a hot soldering iron. In the case of NiCd batteries, this is not that critical. However, in the case of lithium polymer batteries, overheating is a real issue. After soldering the tabs, I was ready to build the first battery pack. After cleaning the charging tabs, I then soldered them to the first positive cell and the last negative cell. One of the original battery packs had a charge monitoring circuit consisting of an NTC thermistor and a capacitor. These were soldered together and the heat shrink tubing was used to isolate the leads. The protection circuit goes in between the negative terminal of the last cell in the series and to the third charging tab, which is the monitoring terminal. Once this step was complete, it was time to begin reassembling the first battery pack. I trimmed any excess tape and soldered the protection circuit in place. I then reassembled the battery pack. It was now time to test the battery pack and see if the cordless screwdriver would work. And it doesn't work. I verified the voltage on the battery pack, and it was fine. It was above the nominal 9.6 volts of the battery pack. I then connected the cordless drill to a regulated supply providing over 9 volts, and it too wouldn't make the drill work. It wants to start, except it seems to either jam or just stop for some reason. The problem seems to lie with the internals of the cordless drill. The next day, I proceeded to build a second battery pack. Once finished, I also measured the voltage of this pack, and it too was okay. I left the last pack for a future video where I will hopefully get both the drill working and maybe build a tab welder. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like what you saw, go ahead and hit that like button and consider subscribing. I regularly put out new videos, so stay tuned for more. You can also find Made to Hack on the web and on social media.